bring the music down just a little bit. Something like that. There we go. Okay. So, ooh. Mic's a little hot. There we go. Ah, we'll leave it. It's fine. I'm gonna start murmuring soon anyway. Okay, so we're doing some sculpting tonight. Hey, Corey, how you doing? This looks like a JoJo stand. Unfortunately, I don't know enough about JoJo to confirm or deny. We have Tucker here, who is naked. Pay no attention to the nudity. And I'm working on the face today. I'm hanging in there myself, Corey. Things have settled down in the work department, but there's always something to be excited by in the bad way. But we're hanging in there. Things are grooving along. What are y'all up to this evening? Oh, cut down of the first spore stream will be uploading tomorrow morning. And I'm trying to do more cut downs. I've made clips out of that to post on TikTok. I'm moving and grooving, shaking and shimmying. Okay, I need to kind of. I thought we'd do the interesting bit and work on the face today. I do want to try and swivel this around. I actually don't like this camera position very much. I'm gonna kind of bring this around to here. Maybe even more. Hold on. We're gonna move this a little further. And then tilt that down like that. Maybe zoom out just a shimmy. Shimmy and a shake here. There we go. That's a little better. Shaking and shimmying. Yes, a very dangerous combo. I recommend avoiding trying to do both at the same time. You could potentially break a hip. Not safe for those who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant, or anybody with a family history of heart conditions. I feel like I need to tape his foot down so that I'm not dealing with him sliding as much, because we are mostly just going to be working on the face today. I have a lot of other stuff I could do elsewhere on the body, but that's not why we're here. Try and get my... This is a little taller than what I was working on the other day, so I need to kind of futz with my positioning of crap here. I think if I put my lamp down here, I can get it a little closer. That seems better. I only have so many hips to break. I hope you don't have more than two. If you do, I recommend consulting a physician. Tucker's face is pretty straightforward. It's not, like, super weird. It's a little exaggerated. He's a cartoon. Ignore the Tucker ween. Speaking of breaking hip, your grandma broke hers. Oh no, pimp, I'm sorry to hear that. You'll accept some extra hip if you gotta sit around. It's always good to share. And then I can push that back. And there we go. That's not bad. Pimp, that's not good news. What happened? Did she fall, or... That's usually what it is. My grandma had a pretty big fall. I don't know, I think it was about 6 months ago. She got lucky, didn't have too many issues, but... We were all a little bit concerned there for a moment. I hope your grandma's healing up all right. How long ago was that? So Tucker's a bit of an interesting guy to design. She didn't even tell your mom until 2 weeks after it happened. My God. Well, sounds like the type to take care of herself. But I hope that she's doing that and not just avoiding the things she needs to do. That's the kind of person I am. I'll just put off health concerns way too long. No, I don't recommend it. So far it hasn't caused me a big issue, but I'm trying to be better about it. Hey there, Kenna. How you doing this evening? We're doing some face carving, which is something I don't have an extreme amount of experience with. I've done it 2, 3, or 10 times, but... Not too many. This is a character I've had in my noodle for quite a while, though, so I'm not too worried. Oh, face. Yeah, we're facing it. Facing it down. Posted your current whip in Discord. Ooh, let's see. Ooh, nice. Hold on. It's gonna be right there. There we go. Check that out. That's looking sick, you know? Oh, the rotting flesh. Very nice. Very, very nice. Look at that. Love the detail on that. Just imagine it's a small Bowser with very different features, then I'll nail it. Thank you, Moody. Why is my chat not showing... on here. Did I do a bad thing? I feel like I'm missing a widget. Edit. Add. What in the hell? My chat has disappeared from my stream manager. I'm Wyatt's muscles and such after that sculpting stream? Well, I'm happy to be inspiration. Glad to hear that. That's all done, by the way. Let me see if I can get that on screen. Speaking of muscles, I did what we talked about, and I've got much more strandy-looking muscles. Can say anything he can't see. I can see the chat until it disappears from the stream, but if I miss anything there, I'm hosed. Okay, hold on. There we go. That's the finished version of that, which I think turned out pretty good. I ended up making that out of actual, like, I rolled out all of these little thin strands and laid them out and then pressed them in and added some roughness and texture, and they look really good. But that took a while. Stream Deities decided things were going too swimmingly tonight. Yeah, gotta start a little bit scuffed, right? Otherwise it's not me. What in the world? Does anybody who has a better brain than me know how to add panels to the stream manager? Ooh, what about reset to default? That should definitely include chat. That's what I'm talking about. There you are. Got you fooligans back up on the screen. Speaking of widgets, there's a new Pokemon called Wigglet that's just a long Diglett. Please tell me you're serious. That's absurd, and I love it. Oh my god. You like fooligans, Moody? I'm gonna need a picture of that one. Please throw that at the Discord. Pull this in. I'm just gonna try and like rough in some of this stuff here. I'm perfectly happy to pull back and build back up. So just gonna kinda try and wing it and see what we like as we go. Please do give me a little notice if I accidentally pull the character out of focus. I'm trying to pay attention to that, but I'll get sucked into it and I might forget. Posting pics. Who this duder? This is my character Tucker, who I've drawn on stream before, but I needed a 3D model for comic reference. I'm slowly but surely working on a comic that Emily and I are writing together based on a show concept I had in school that I decided I want to just make myself. And this is Tucker. And he is a wannabe criminal mastermind. He is approximately 38 with the body of a 70-year-old man. Not literally, but apparently. That is... I don't even have words. What in the hell? And it's called Wigglet. What is happening in the Pokemon world? I mean, it's not like they haven't always been weird. He's an eel? Is he really? Is he water type? Benjamin Button. No, more just takes very bad care of his body. Yeah, so he's got this rather unshapely form. It's stylized, obviously, but big belly on this really thin, wiry frame. Kind of muscly in some places, really thin in others. The spine obviously needs a lot more detail. But, Ganjamin Druggen, exactly. A Ganjamin Druggen. Yes. He's lived a life that your body wouldn't be happy with, and it shows. But so we're gonna sink in the eyes pretty far here. I might need to shift the camera again. A life of crime, a life of attempted crime mostly. He's not extremely successful up until the beginning of the story. I'm swiveling back. I apologize. I know we just swiveled, but we're swiveling again. I can't get in there enough. The camera's in my way. I think I need to drop my chair down. There we go. So I'm going to try and do this, but my plan is to do this in phases, right? I'm going to get in these rough shapes, and then I'm going to try and duplicate them over to the left side, and then we'll go into another level of detail. I'm hoping that'll do the trick for me. Lazy Susan camera setup. I actually upgraded over here, and I installed a curtain rod, which is why it's a little bouncy. It should probably be a piece of conduit, but I still haven't swapped it out. And my camera is on a... like articulated arm that's attached to that, so I can like slide it back and forth, and I can swivel all around from the anchor point that's overhead, and there's nothing in the way of my arms, which is really nice. Makes it a lot easier to work on stuff over here. It also means there's not much point in having a face cam over here, but I don't think that's really a problem for these kinds of streams. You don't really need to see reactions and stuff like that. Mostly just hear me yammering about what I'm doing is probably good enough. Yeah, this has been a really nice upgrade. I'm glad I did that. Wasn't sure I wanted to deal with figuring it out, and it meant drilling fresh holes in the wall, which I try to avoid. You don't know yet. Oh, you don't think it's known yet, but people are thinking water ground. It's got to be water ground, right? I mean, if it's an eel, there has to be water in there somewhere. Let me see. I might want something a little scrapier and a little less loopy. Okay, wait a minute. I was looking all over for this yesterday, and it was just in my box. Like, it was just in the toolbox. I could have phrased that better, but I'm going to stick with it. Okay, so we've got a little bit of marking for where we want everything. His nose is like really pointy, so that's probably just going to get layered on. Moody wins the horoscope race today. That's a very early Austin quote. Speaking of quotes, guess who I was taking a look at today? Trying to perform a bit of a Ganondorf-esque resurrection. Corey, Moody was reading your mind. The protagonist of Cave Story. No. Not quite. Our old cybernetic friend, Huey Botman, may be making his triumphant return sooner than you think. Because more of that code is still working than I thought it was. And it looks like I'm going to be able to indeed hook him up. How could that hint not lead me to quote? Fair enough, you got me there. I forgot that was the name of the protagonist. But, you know, speaking of quote lists and stream bots and whatnot, yeah, Botman will be back in the world. I did a couple preliminary tests with him today, and he seems to be functional. Hey, Katz is here. How you doing? Doing just about everything that Stream Elements is currently doing. So as soon as I can get him hooked up to the... technically correct. The best kind of correct. I'm looking forward to the Futurama reboot. I'm worried that, you know, technically speaking, the mouse is probably involved. But I choose to hope. I believe that there's a chance. That it'll turn out okay. I think that's not coming out until like 2023 or something. How you doing today, Katz? I believe. What they drawn up there? I don't know. There's some scantily clad female. There's a tongue. There's a goose. I see a rabbit. A very happy man playing guitar, kind of angry happy. And apparently it's his face that we're talking about. Satan has a hold of you. Emily and I are going to see the Book of Mormon for the first time. It's the main reason we're going to New York. Well, Emily's seen it. I have not seen it. But why is it 2008 Pope Burnham's tongue? I don't know. You know, I'm going to be honest. I don't keep as much track of Bo Burnham's tongue progression as I think you might. As much of a fan as I am. Of the tongue, I mean. Bo Burnham too, but that tongue though. Gollum? No, not Gollum. How you doing, Sofa? This is my own character, Tucker. Although he is similarly unattractive. It's insane, Kenna. Yeah, Emily has been wanting me to see it since our relationship began, even before then, honestly. So, 9 years we've known each other? Maybe 9.5? It's a fairly good start. Robot Bear hasn't seen it either, and he wants to. Yeah, I mean, it took a long time for him to get me to finally go. It's not that I didn't want to see it, it's just that, it takes forever to get me to do things. Which is not news to anyone here. It's not news to Emily either. I'm excited. I'll send my my review to Robot Bear. Hopefully I can help fuel the fire. Clay's a little on the soft side today. Lie to you? This character is just a really good guy and not at all based on my own insecurities. Also, the Book of Mormon, the play, is a one-to-one retelling of the text of the original Book of Mormon. If you went to New York City, we'd see Sleep No More and some off-Broadway shows. I feel that. We're going to be doing tons of touristy stuff while we're there. Because I've only been once in all of my entire days of life. I keep squishing his belly button, and it's bothering me. This is not on camera, but I need to fix it for a moment. Honestly, I should just flatten out the belly button and do it again later. This has happened too many times. We'll revisit the belly button. There. Now he's Kyle XY. That's a deep cut. The child brain of Austin's brainchild brain. That's easy for you to say. The big productions do national tours anyway. Yes. But we wanted to go on a trip, and it was in New York. And, felt like fun to go see it there. Honestly, what it came down to was that was the current show. Surely you're going there to check out the 55 square foot apartment. You know, Moody, actually, you're right. After you showed me that, I just decided that I had to have it. And we booked the next flight. But yeah, we're going to be out of town the 11th through the 18th. So there will not be any streams that week. But I'll be back the next week, as will Emily. Probably going to be doing some Spore again on Friday this week, which I'm looking forward to. As I said, there's a cut down of the stream that's going to upload tomorrow morning. That's all queued up and ready to go. Hey, Sky's here. Looking at what's on Broadway these days, and honestly, Book of Mormon is one of the few lately. Oh, really? Is the list looking pretty sparse? I may have been a bit too severe. Looks like a threatening SCP of some kind. At this point, 100%. And when it's done, it's not going to be much prettier, to be honest. This is my man, Tucker. I'm hoping we can get a good amount of progress in the face today. Hey, Sofa, thanks for the resub. 7 months. Rock and roll. Thank you. Phantom is closing in February, finally opening a theater with its retirement. Oh. I saw somebody saying the Phantom was leaving a theater, and the response was, good luck getting them out. As in, Phantom's theater will finally be open for a new production. Ah, I see. I feel like I want kind of a smirk. I don't think I should worry too much about the mouth right now, to be honest with you. I don't know why I'm doing that. I'm doing that because I don't want to think about the face shape. That's why. I'm hiding from myself. I gotta pass these large shapes over to the other side. And I gotta do it now. That's not how it works for everybody, but for me, it's easier to copy things while it's in each phase rather than trying to work all the way through one side and then duplicate on the other side. I think that's probably how it is for most people, but not everybody. And as somebody who works in digital a lot, you know, it gets weird. Like my brain is just like, no, just complete one side and then turn on mirror. And you're done. Not today, bitch. Pet the damn dog. I can, but you're not going to see her very well. Lola.
Lola, come here. Lola?
Come here, puppy. Here. I can offer you a dog paw. Come here, puppy. Here, wait. Ready? Proof of dog. I promise it's the real dog. Look at toe beans and everything. That's a good girl.
Who's your pup?
Here, we can do this. There she is. Say hi, Lola. Hold on, don't move yet. Oh, the camera.
Down you go, pup. Good girl. Em, are you out there somewhere?
Yeah.
Can you give Lola a treat? Or are you in the middle of something?
Yeah.
Let me get her a treat. She deserves one. I see this just insult also. Breaking news. These redeems are wasting my time. And frankly, I think you could do better. That was a collective. That was a nice group insult. Oh, I see it. I see it, Kenna. I'm thinking about it. I'm gonna say, let's see. You know, I'm gonna guess high and say 6 foot. Cause I have no idea how tall you are. Chug Jug? I'm gonna have to postpone that Chug Jug. Chug Jug is out of commission. Really? I mean, do I really think you're that tall? No. But it's no fun to guess the middle of the ground all the time and kind of, I mean, like, playing the numbers, sure, but it's no fun. I think you seem like a tall girl. No, frankly, I think you seem like you're probably short. I think you're probably short, but I don't know. Even better? Help me. What's the answer? Are you right down the middle? Five, six on the tall side of average. Oh. I still would have been wrong. My first guess was around 5'9", which is still tallish, but I decided to just go for broke. I'm gonna have to reject your Chug Jug. Sorry, sofa. Chug Jug will be back soon, though. It's freshly cleaned. It's just currently empty. 5'6". That's a good height. Good solid height. Ooh, Sky, same height as Kinna. Same height clan. I am 6'2" if I don't slouch, and somewhere around 4'3" with my normal posture. It means I can wear heels with most guys and be equal or shorter. That's good. I've heard that as a positive for middle of the road heights from quite a lot of girls. Guess your height, cats? I thought I guessed your height once before. Have we not done this one with you before? Well, now I gotta go short. I went tall last time. Let's go. Let's go 5'3". About 5'3". 5'2". You know what? Let's take it all the way down. Not yet? I'm sticking with 5'2". I don't remember how old you are, so that would, you know, help. I think you're an adult person. Your older sister is 5'2". You're exactly 6". Well, you're either an adult person or a very tall child. Exactly 6". That's nice and clean. Easy to remember. Good for filling out forms if you don't have a lot of space. Imagine being short. I don't have to imagine. I was very short for a long time, and then I just sprouted up like a beanpole. The joys of being a late bloomer. All your friends are, like, way taller than you. And then all of a sudden you're just like, hello down there. But I still had tons of friends who were even taller than me. Helped keep me in line. Kept me from getting too cocky. I had a buddy in school that was 6'5". Anyone want to borrow some inches being tall as Lim? You hit your head on shit all the time, but you can reach good shelves. See, but the thing is, a lot of things, I don't hear about it often, but you have the problem with, you can reach the top shelves, but the bottom shelves are a lot more of a pain in the ass to get to. You're 6 foot in skates. So how much height does a pair of skates add? Like 4 inches or so? I was 4'10 until I was 14 and then 5'6 at 16. Good God, are your knees okay, Kinna? Did they ever fully recover? My knees are shot, but not because of that. Ooh, ballet will do that. Hell. Yikes. Yeah, I was fortunate enough to be a polywog. I was a swimmer in water polo, so... That's all pretty easy on your joints and stuff. In that department, I'm doing pretty good. Okay, so, should be kind of going up like that, and then curving into here... And then down there, so I want to take out this section, but it's going the wrong way for my hand. So how long did you ballet for? Moody, you don't like being tall? What don't you like about it? How tall are you? You're taller than me, aren't you? I feel like I remember talking about that at some point and you said you were like 6'3 or something. Retro gaming community challenge ended because 100%? Ooh, cool. All right. Looks like we're going to have an exciting couple of weeks after we get back from New York. The cooking stream is going to be most likely that first week after we get back from New York, and we'll do retro gaming the following week. retro gaming is going to be, we're going to start Thousand Year Door, which was never my personal favorite, but it'll be fun to do on stream. I when I say that, I should say I never really played it. And then I tried to when I was older, and I just didn't really have the patience for it. 6 years, but it came from musical theater and gymnastics, so I skipped like 3 levels. 12 hours of ballet a week. Good lord. That's a lot of dancing. No wonder your knees are shut. That'll do it. I think I need something flatter.
Can you pull something down?
Thousand Year Door is a retro game. Does it qualify? Should I do something older than that? I feel like it qualifies for Twitch. GameCube counts as retro now. It's 18 years old, right? Is that old enough to count? If it's not old enough to count, then I can pick something else.
No.
Emily votes for Thousand Year Door. It was your favorite game for a while? I never had a GameCube. My first Nintendo system that I owned was the Switch. Or it was the Wii, I'm sorry. And you're 6 foot, okay. Paper Mario is adorable. Yes. Just 6 feet. Yeah. Go ahead and throw that into quotes. Good call. I'm missing a tool here. Confound it. This one is basically the same tool, it's just larger than I was hoping for. I'll say it needs to be 21 years old so it's allowed to drink. Okay, so then Thousand Year Door doesn't count. But in order to placate Emily, we'll still play Thousand Year Door. But that means I need to pick something else for what qualifies as retro gaming. As if I wasn't complaining about my just 6 feet. I mean, it is too many feet to keep track of. So, I would complain about it. I feel like Austin is sculpting my sleep paralysis demon. I'm not sure how to feel about that one. I'm inside your mind, Kenna. To me, retro is before 3D. I don't know if that quite qualifies. I think we've got plenty of 3D games that would qualify as retro. Especially to a modern audience. If it's any consolation, Kenna, well, there's a scarier version of him that is fairly akin to my sleep paralysis demon. Oh God, please no, I'm sorry. Is that to me being in your mind? There's no escape. Play Mother 3. That doesn't seem like a good idea. That doesn't seem like something that will go well in my incapable hands. It's a place of madness. 0 out of 10, do not recommend. Yeah, trust me. I feel ya. It's a scary place inside my mind too, but I'll take your word for it. We don't have to trade. Play Zelda Oracle games. Go for Ganon ending. Zelda Oracle games. I'm not sure I even know what those are. Speaking of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom, looking very exciting. I trade minds with another spooky nerd for a day or so. Careful what you wish for. I have no issues with my height. That's good, Katz. That's good. Moody's allowed to want to be a different height. Choice is yours. Moody, if you could pick what height you were, what height would you pick? Say it right now, because I do have a monkey's paw on hand. Game Boy Color, Ages and Seasons. What? I was gonna ask more questions, but I don't think I needed any more than that. You just showed the monkey paw on stream. That's true. It's the cuddliest monkey paw you've ever seen. Oracle of Ages, Oracle of Seasons on Game Boy Color. Oh, Pimp was helping me understand what you were talking about. I see now. I see. Well, what's the dealio with those? There's a kangaroo with boxing gloves, so you know it's good. That is, I mean, second only to a fishing minigame. You're looking for a kangaroo with boxing gloves. Oracle of Seasons is one of your favorite Zelda games. When you beat one, you can use a code to carry data to the other. Do you get to keep all your Pokemon? You've never played them, but you love the manga. And if you do both, you can get a secret ending and fight Ganon. Oh, so that's what you're saying. I need to beat both of them in order to fight Ganon Dork. Got him. He'll never fully recover. After a joke like that, I bet he'll end up mummified in a cave. That's me just spitballing off the top of the old noodle. Coming up with ideas all on my own. Been watching theory videos about Tears of the Kingdom. Anybody follow Zeltic? They're quite good at content mining the Zelda games, but they have very good theories. Well, that's a possibility. The old Zelda games. Let me see. I might end up having to play something on 64. Might be the only way to do it. The Seven Sages actually studied at disc school to embarrass Ganon into sealment. There was a whole, like, roast rap battle. It was awesome. That's not burning magical hair on Ganon's head. That's the fire that the sages were spitting. Breaking news. Katz, I'm sorry. I don't want to get your name wrong while I'm insulting you. Eats absolute nightmare fuel for breakfast, and I do mean that literally. Check the Discord. He was so hurt it took 10,000 years for a comeback, and he still hasn't spoken. Princess Ruto had the best verse. I don't know. I gotta give the best verse to Link. It wasn't very detailed, but it was cutting. Days till Tears of the Kingdom. That's honestly not that bad. When you put it that way, I'm hopeful. That was a collab between Link and... I feel like I'm going to catch heat here. Fi or Fi? Possibly Fo or Fum. Cursed canon with the pain of being ghosted by Link. That would hurt any of us, to be honest. Responding between matches of Strive. Maybe 5-2, being short, it's fee. Thank you, pimp. Being short sounds fun to you. 5-2 seems like a good height. I support you in your quest to lose height. Make it happen. If need be, Moody, I will come over there and chop your feet off. That'll at least get you started. It's pretty weird that he goes fee fi fo fum. I smell the blood of an Englishman. Like, why an Englishman? They have a very telltale scent signature in their blood. Honestly, most people know this, Kinna, and I'm not sure why you don't. I was more hung up on the Mon, like it's a Jamaican giant. They're pretty stinky. They smell like boiled fish and beans on toast. Anyone got a stack of bricks and a press? No, that's the slow method, Moody. Jamaicans eating English muffins for breakfast. Totally. Ewie? What's wrong, Sky? Did you finally take a look at what we're creating here? Or do you also not like boiled fish and beans on toast? 1,000 ton hydraulic press time. Hydraulic press versus one tall Moody. I forgot to cut my fingernails. Damn it. Definitely should have done that. In case you think this is a very low frowny face, this is just the bottom of the chin. Oh, fish you. You're not a fish fan? My mom hates fish. She always says fish are friends, not food, whenever we eat fish. But I know that she doesn't think they're friends. She just thinks they're not food. Has everyone had a stint of binging hydraulic press videos? I think it's a rite of passage to be a human in this century. Everyone's found themselves on that side of the internet at one point or another. Long ago in my darkest times. back in the horrifying days of yesteryear. They must have had a major boom during the pandemic. Did it on Switch, came back and did it on my Steel Soul save file. What's that, Sofa? Oh, got platinum! GG! Well done, Sofa. That is better than I will ever do, I can promise you that. It is very nice to see there seems to be actual movement on Silksong, albeit minor. You love pork. Me too. I mostly like pork sausage and tenderloin, but pork chops can be pretty good too. There's this one particular vid of a Furby getting pressed. It's the rawest video I've ever seen. It changed my life. I've never been the same. I get sick every time I eat pork. Can't figure out why. Is it possible to have an allergy to pork? Seems specific. But maybe. I don't know. Maybe whoever makes pork for you just prepares it wrong. Are you the one making the pork? Maybe you don't know how to prepare pork. Maybe you're blaming the pork, and you should be blaming somebody else. Probably I'm allergic to raw onions, seafood, a bunch of fruits, pollen, aspartame? You have an aspartame allergy? I've heard of that. I've never met somebody who had one. No diet soda for you, Kenna. Man, the world is not friendly to you. I have a lot of allergies, but fortunately none of them are edible. Because I like me some munchables. So, that is good news. Not to rub your face in it, that's not my intention. Your mom makes a good pork chop. My mom makes a good pork chop, too. I was never able to replicate it. My mom makes bomb-ass potato salad. The German kind with the chunky potatoes. I mean, it's not like the German kind, but it has chunky potatoes. So that's what I always say. She always says it's her grandma's recipe, and I'm like, yeah, but now it's your recipe. That's how that works. Like, she probably got that recipe from somebody. And the times, they are changing. My brother's allergic to amoxicillin. How's that even possible? That's bad news. Derived from penicillin, which is derived from mold, so it's basically a severe mold allergy. I'm allergic to mold. I wonder if I should be worried about penicillin and amoxicillin. Gina, you have a lot of allergies. Sorry to hear that. Unlikely? That's good news. George Takei is a part of the Avatar live action show. Well, George Takei was a part of the Avatar cartoon show also, so. He was the warden in the prison that Haru and company go to. The Earth Nation people. RN Jesus had it out for you. My allergy passport is stacked. But if you ever find yourself in a game of allergy bingo, I mean, you got the win for sure. Stupid autocorrect.
Damn.
Technology. Trying to tell me what to say. I'm being censored. Do some allergy tarot readings. The problem is it would just come through like noise. Just be white noise. If you have all the allergies, you blow out the tarot gods, spirits, system. I don't know how tarot readings work. Can you eat peanut butter? That's really good news. You've met exactly two people IRL with more allergies than you. Can you be insulted? I did insult you. I fully insulted you. I said you eat nightmare fuel. Did you ask for another one? Alright. Alright, alright. I'm gonna be honest. News is coming out. People are talking about it. It's spreading. It's spreading like wildfire. Cats. Cats is hungry for attention. Cats likes insults. Cats likes to be hurt. A little bit of a masochist. What's more insulting than being ignored? I would say being shot. That's probably more insulting. I would be insulted if somebody shot me. Just so you know, if you're looking to hurt my feelings, that'd be a pretty efficient way to pull it off. Are you just gonna ask individually for a list of Kenna's allergies, Sofa? You can have soy, milk, tree nuts, wheat, allergic to both fish and shellfish. Good lord. On this stream, you would know. I'm a lot better about not ignoring Moody. It was just a streak of bad luck. And my really, really poor attention skills. In practice, it's pretty easy. Just don't eat seafood, fruit salad, or raw onions. So you can eat cooked onions? That works out just fine. You love raw onions. I don't know if I've ever heard somebody say that. I'm okay with raw onions. They're not, like, the best. I could do without them. Especially if I could eat cooked onions. Seafood, I would be pretty bummed if I couldn't have. I likes my water types. Them's tasty. My dad's a chemist and figured it out once. It's the oil in the onions, the part that makes you cry, and that cooks out when you eat, or that cooks out when you cook them enough. Cooks out when you eat them enough, Austin. Nice. Just keep eating that onion until the oils cook out of it. Well, that's very interesting. Does your dad have a way to make onions not make you cry, other than wearing dorky goggles? Oh, so there's a question. Does the fume from onions being cut, do the fumes from onions being cut also cause an allergic reaction for you? Like, do you have to stay out of the room when someone's cutting onions? Yes. Oof. If you slap it enough, it won't make you cry, but the pain will. I'm fine abusing onions. I can live with that guilt. We can't have raw onions in here, but we can have dried diced onion that we put water on or use onion powder. I see. So the, what'd you say it was a protein or an oil? The oil. Not present in those, because it's all dried out. Well, that's good, at least. At least you can still have onions in your life. Any point goals? You're sitting on 40K. Well, there's always more push-ups. We've revised that to clapping push-ups. I don't know if I changed the description. But I think the next one is... What is it? 3 clapping push-ups? Is that what I did? Purple? You can't even see my headband. Believe it or not, I'm not even wearing one right now. I know. Austin not wearing a headband? Tantamount to public nudity.
I'm an honest man.
Purple headband. I typed green and hit enter, and it said this reward on cooldown. We'll do green next. Right now it says 5? Well, I guess it's 5 clapping push-ups then. Lo and behold. Purple right there already. Not fast enough, Moody. You gotta be quick. We just trust it's purple. I showed you the purple. It was on screen. And it's on my head right now. I'm an honest man. And honestly, I needed to get my hair out of my face anyway, so... I really need a haircut. But I'm waiting. I'm gonna get one a little closer to the New York trip. So that I don't look as much like a hobo. For the, for pictures while we're on adventures. If you take out the color picker, you can see that the clay has taken a slightly higher red and blue hue. Embrace the hobo. I do most of the time. It's my default persona. It's who I feel I am deep inside. My reflection does show who I am inside. And that's a hobo in a headband. Who is that girl I see staring straight back at me? When will my reflection... Ooh, my voice is going out on me. I'm also not being very loud. there too much light on that, or are you seeing enough of what's going on? I know it's just iterative progress anyway, but I want to make sure it's visible. Wow, that shape is looking nice. Maybe I could make it. Sorry, excuse the camera wiggle. Hold on to your lunch. Playing master mode, because what's the point of 100% normal mode? Sure, whatever you say, Sofa. And they put Silver Lonely, I assume that means Lionel, but he's all by his lonesome, so probably, in the Great Plateau, but it doesn't even give you weapons to kill it. Yeah, that was my experience when I played Master Mode. I stumbled across that handsome gentleman, and I was like, what the hell? And I think the game there is you're supposed to avoid him. My camera don't wiggle wiggle. It folds. I love that they released a full version of that song, like, oh, I don't know, 2.5 months after the trend was over. Like, you gotta turn that shit out quicker if you're gonna go for that. It's too late now. The trend can't be resurrected. But it's okay, it's done just in time for them to use that in a commercial for dog food. I'm so disappointed by Unholy. Like, it's not bad, but... wait, Unholy? What's Unholy? Is that what I'm talking about? Because I don't know the names of things. Tried throwing bombs at it for like 20 minutes. Yeah, I would just bounce on it. And Sofa, this is a model sculpt, like character model sculpt of my character Tucker, who is the star of a comic I am slowly but surely working on. There won't be anything shown from that until I have a few issues ready to put out there. When I do, they'll go out on my website, but Emily and I are writing it together. And he is the star of the show. Unholy is the new Sam Smith song. TikTok song that goes, Mommy don't know daddy's getting hot in the body shop doing something unholy. I don't know if I know that one. Or maybe I just haven't been paying attention to the lyrics. Hum it for me. Just to yourself. And I'm going to try and sense it. I'm not sure I know which one that is. Maybe we're not on the same corners of TikTok. Is that one of the ones that's, like, everywhere? I like the one he did for Spectre. I'm pretty sure I saw that movie. I wanted Idris Elba to play Bond. When the rumors about that first started coming around, I wasn't really into it. And I really came around to it, because he's like super suave. That head shape is definitely coming along. Writing's on the walls. That's the song Sam Smith did for Spectre. Still haven't seen No Time to Die. Really want to. I haven't seen that either. I haven't watched a Bond film in a long time. Especially not a new one, but none at all, really. I'm done getting my teeth kicked in for the day. Time to look at death continue to be born live on Twitch. I think he's handsome. Face only a mother could love. And, haven't fully decided yet, but I don't think we'll ever see or even hear about Tucker's mother. There might be some stuff with his father. I haven't decided. There was in the original version of the story. I'm his mother? Well. And I guess it's not a face a mother could love. Sorry, Tucker. Put a link in Discord with the song. Also a good piece of art in that TikTok. Oh, cool. Let me see. Just a second. Let me just gouge out this eye socket for a moment. I think I like that eye placement. It's a little low. Not too low, and if you put the head, you should keep in mind he's a little foreshortened at your angle, because he's looking slightly down, and you're slightly above the can, or above his head. All right, let me see. Mama Austin, no. Saw this guy on YouTube. He gets platinum trophies, and he cheated on Hollow Knight and said he needed content. I would be pissed too. Where are we, Discord? New mentions. Hold on, let me... Wait a second. Oh, there we go. Oh, how you don't know how to keep your business clean. Oh, I haven't heard this. I'm sorry, I don't have the artwork on screen at the same time. I wasn't fast enough. I didn't think. There we go. That's pretty cool artwork. I dig it. That's pretty cool. I hope that wasn't too redonkulously loud. That clip of the song is sick, but the rest of the song is just all right. People seem to be doing that almost on purpose lately, just because of the way things are being consumed. It wasn't loud? Okay, cool. That's too low. It's pretty good placement-wise, but it's a little too low. I'll have to fill some of that in. That's okay. Moody, did you want to make that an actual quote, or are you just poking at my word choice? I thought about adding that as an automatic quote ad, or maybe even to have Botman ask. Right now it looks like the silence from Doctor Who. Emily has told me a few times that I would probably like that show. I've never actually watched it. I've seen some clips from it, and I do seem to like it. And I know recent Doctors were played by both Matt Smith and what's his name? Skinny guy, usually has spiky hair. The actual quote wasn't as good, so it'd be cheating. Oh. You don't want to attribute better quotes than what I actually said to me? It's pretty rude, Moody. History is written by the winners, you know. So, if you refuse to write history, that makes you a loser. Tenant? What, like what's his name? Chris Nolan movie? Getting the perfect phrasing in the actual quote is half the game. I was almost tempted to add no headband. It's tantamount to public nudity. Austin, I already knew I was a loser. Well, no, you didn't have to go and make it sad. We're all losers here. Life's more fun that way. He's the best doctor. Oh, David Tennant. Right, yes. Yes, Tennant. That's what I was trying to think of. Thank you. I swear to God, my attention span is like 4 seconds long. Okay, I think the eye sockets have made this much more unsettling to look at, and I apologize for that already. Some are more than others. You're right, I'm pretty fantastic. But the rest of you guys... just disappointing. No, I'm kidding. I'm King Loser. That was actually what they wrote in my yearbook. Most likely to continue being a loser. And they were right. At least you're king. Yeah, I'm pretty sure self-proclaimed kings aren't kings. Actually, those are the only kings, now that I think about it. How disappointing are you on a scale of 1 to 10? 11, because it's not on the scale, which is a disappointment. Yeah, it's just disappointing that Super Mario Maker 2 doesn't have the same ring to it. No, it doesn't. No. Doesn't quite have that flow. Speaking of Super Mario Maker 2, I did actually re-download it. And, I'm just gonna go ahead and say, with some time away from them, I now fully understand exactly how horrible my levels are. Coming back to them and basically looking at them blind and fresh, good lord. Really good dodge? Thanks, cats, I do what I can. My disappointment is the square root of negative 100. Definitely a 10, but also doesn't exist. And you brought math into this, which is also disappointing. I'll show you real disappointment. I got everything ready to make blueberry scones with lemon glaze, and our oven broke. Okay, well, that's a pretty big letdown. Isn't every level on Super Mario Maker 2 blind? Not when they're your own level. Moody, that really blows. I think we've got the beginnings of a good smirk here. You can kind of see that this corner of the mouth goes up a little bit more than this one does. And that is on purpose. I think I'm going to need to add like some more mass up here to support that shape. So I'm going to try to touch that less, he says. Touching it more. But that's the beauty of this medium, is I can always add more. I want to try, like, soapstone carving just to kind of break into a purely subtractive sculpting method, subject, medium, style, whatever. The broiler on my oven broke a few years ago, and I'm always sad about it. Making sandwiches has never been more disappointing. Oh yeah, you gotta have the broiler to get that perfect amount of crisp on your sandwich. Your mom started a fire in your oven? My mom did that too. Although for my mom it wasn't her fault. I don't know what the case is with your mom. I'm not trying to throw blame around here. But it seemed like you already did, so I'm just jumping on the bandwagon because I'm that kind of guy. But I remember when I was a little kid, I went to my mom. I was like, "Mom, I think the oven's on fire." And she was on the phone, and she's like, "No, it's not. That's just the heating element glows." And I'm like, "No, Mom, there's, like, fire." And then she comes over, and the heating element had cracked. And there was just an open flame in the oven. Tried substituting the air fryer for the broiler once, and it basically desiccates bread instead of toasting it. I don't know that word. What does desiccates mean? Makes it super dry. Ah, I see. It's like removing water, like a mummy in the desert. Ah, so, like our friend here. He's really coming along. I'm very pleased with how he's looking right now. I need to do some jawline stuff and things like that, but I'm going to actually avoid that until after the stream because I don't think I'm going to be able to get a very good angle on it, and that's not going to be very nice to watch. At least this way you can kind of see what I'm doing. But I do think I still need to bring the ISO down just a smidgen, give you a little more detail to look at there. Yeah, that's a bit better. He already looks really cool. Thanks, Sofa. Put aluminum foil on the bottom of the stove where it says don't put aluminum here. Ah, well, that'll do it. There's one thing I learned about cooking from setting various fires of my own. It's always follow the instructions. Emily's roommate in college put a plastic cutting board in the warming tray under their oven because he thought it was a drawer. I made a very big mess. And very nearly could have killed Emily's bird. The part I'm really looking forward to with Tucker here is going to be adding his clothes. I mean, this is all well and good and, you know, important to getting the body shape right, but I'm not doing, like, tons of surface detail across his body. I did the rib cage here because I just kind of... I don't really know why. Let me see. There you go. You can kind of see that in there. Because it's going to be covered. Have I seen what the silence looks like? I have not. I have no idea what that is. That's not a fart, by the way. That's my back on the chair. There's nothing more suspicious than saying something isn't a fart. Oh, I have seen the silence. Yes, I totally know what that is. And, yeah, I definitely see it for now, but that'll pass. But 100%. Hold on, let me see. Yeah. There's a little bit of nightmare fuel for you.
I'm gonna go to bed.
Oh. I'm gonna say goodnight to Emily. I'll be right back, folks. You heard it, you dispersed it. She didn't hear you, but I let her know what you said, Kim. It would be scary to know you've forgotten what you've seen. Oh, is that what the silence is? Is that that one? I've heard about that. The one that after you've seen it, like if you're no... Oh, I forgot that was going to happen again. It doesn't come back. Or you don't remember it or whatever. As soon as it's not in your vision, you don't remember it was there or that you ever saw it. There we go. Must be a lonely existence. That's for sure. I think the sculpture should be named Fluffy. You know, I gotta say, you hit the nail on the head. I hope this is helpful for anybody who's trying to relax and just kind of hang out before bed, you know. If you want, we could spend more time working on the groin. That's also an option. We've got groin work to do. No, that's pretty much done. On the contrary, I was asleep until 10 minutes before this dream. Now that's the strategy right there. It's almost 2 a.m. for you. It's only 10:40 here. Didn't sleep the other day. I don't have a clock in my room. I don't trust her to wake up for her alarm, and she had a doctor's appointment. I get that. Yeah. Sometimes it's easier to just stay up through the night. I used to do that all the time in school because I would take until the last possible minute to finish my projects. And then, well, I would just have to pull two or three all-nighters in order to get the project done. Too busy chaining up bikes, moving plants inside, and boarding up windows. Yeah, adrenaline will keep you going. I think that's working out. It's not super centered. Oh my god, that's right, you're in Florida. Sofa, holy shit. How's that going? Are you guys staying dry for now? I forgot about that. Yeah, stay safe. Make sure to tip the pizza guy, yeah. It's like the keys to a sports car. Hasn't hit us in jacks yet, but when it does by morning, it's only hardly gonna be category 4 instead of being 2 miles per hour away from a Cat 5. Well, that's something at least. Make sure to shoot us a message, yeah? Let us know you guys are doing alright. I'll keep my eye on the news. I'll be fine in your trailer close to the river. It does sound mildly concerning. I can't quite get at this the way that I need to. I'm thinking next art stream might be some Photoshop painting. I've actually been wanting to. I did kind of a sketch of a just a fun one to do a better kind of fully rendered Alvin Lynn the Wranglin Pangolin. I was just doodling the other day and I kind of liked the way it was looking. Thought it might be fun. It's almost 1 now and I want pizza. Well, don't go and say that. Now I want pizza. Can't do that to people. And you did that to yourself in the first place. I was able to avoid the craving the first time. Advanced Alvin. Alvin final form. There might be a slice downstairs. Should you grab it? I think yes. I think in life, when you have the opportunity for pizza, you have to take it. It's your mom's birthday? Oh, happy birthday, Mama Pimpito. Pizza's kind of the perfect food, though, right? Like, peak of humanity's culinary advancement. I mean, we all know that I think that. No, I actually hate pizza. It's, like, my least favorite food. A slice made is a slice earned. Oh, yeah, good question, Moody. Did she get cake? And if so, what kind? I have thoughts on pizza. It's more of a social advancement than a culinary one. Ooh. We're getting intense into the pizza fandom right now. Could slice it again to make more. There you go. Just duplicate the pizza. Checkmate, atheists. It was a good try, Corey. We all know pizza should have won the Tumblr Sex Event contest. It does have the largest fandom. I can't think of anything more popular than pizza. Except for, like, Oxygen. People seem to be pretty into that. Might actually be more people that are a fan of Oxygen or a fan of pizza than Oxygen. Toby Fox's fanfiction celebrating that contest was really nice. There was a fanfiction from Toby Fox about the Sexy Man contest. I prefer water to Oxygen. So that makes you a fish then. Actually, I guess fish also like Oxygen. They just like their Oxygen with a little bit of water. Or do I tolerate oxygen like hydrogen? You prefer CO2, you're a druid. Is that a trait of druids? Another insult. Cats. Cats. My man, my friend. The news is broken. Hear ye, hear ye. Cats is amazing at Super Mario Maker 2 is actually only kind of okay at Super Mario Maker 2. Spread the word. Tell your friends. It's a lie. I'm a special druid. I'm more plant than human. Thank the DM for allowing it. You thank the DM. I pray to no god, man or god. Cats is actually someone else, and my name is complimenting them. Oh, is that right? Way to deflect. We've brought it up so many times, and now all of a sudden Cats is somebody else. A likely story, Cats. A likely story. Free healing cantrip, but you have to take a rest after every action. I definitely read that as free healing catnip, and I thought you were about to start promoting organic pet products. Next you'll tell us the 2 isn't for Mario Maker 2, but you meant 2, so you're also amazing. I won't deny that I'm just kinda okay. I appreciate that humility, not Cats. I'm not going back to calling you numbers, we've already made the switch, so I guess now you're not Cats. Although it does raise questions about who the hell Cats is. But I also can't really confirm it. That's okay, I've confirmed it for you. That part's taken care of. You don't need to worry about that. I always take the most risky quests and apparently always roll nat 20s. Hey, you know, good for you. If you're rolling nat 20s in life, then you shall want for nothing. Fair enough. That's what I do here, Cats. Or, I guess not Cats. I'll get used to it. I just corrected myself from Cat to Cats. Now I gotta correct from Cats to not Cats. Soon you're going to tell me you have an actual name, and that I just don't believe. Yes, cats as numbers. Or not cats as numbers. Damn it. I'll get there eventually. I don't adapt quickly to change. Just tell Corsenton. No, Sky is here also. I don't know if Sky's still floating around, but Sky was definitely here earlier. The artist formerly known as. pretty soon Numbers is going to come in and tell us their name is just a symbol. I'm going to change my name again in 27 days. Alright. I'm just going to pick a name for you. How do you like Phil? I don't care. It's been decided. You're Phil now. I've never changed my name before. You've changed your name like 3 times. What are you talking about? I've changed my name a couple of times. I don't suspect I'll be doing it again. Share with the class, you all need new names now? Okay. I'm gonna call you Crumpet. Pimp, your name is now Leopold. Corey, I'm gonna go with. How do you like Alfonso? I'm making my own die. I have the bowling ball paints and everything. You need bowling ball paints to make die? 2 Leos now? You're right. You're right. That makes things complicated. No, but now. No. Leo becomes Thomas. Yeah, exactly, Moody. Cats wouldn't accept my compliments. So I changed my name to one just to make them regret doing so. So is it going to go back to Numbers at the end of this saga? Is that what you're telling me? Alfonso was a D&D character I made when I was 9 or 10. It does not jibe with me at all. So is that a no? On one hand, I'm hearing no jibe, but on the other hand, I'm hearing it's a character you created. With a random 8 in there. No, we can't be mixing it up like that. Probably a completely new name. Alright. When you show up, you have to announce yourself as Phil. And then I'm not going to remember what the hell you're talking about, and I'm going to be like, who's Phil? And you have to be like, you know who Phil is. And then I'm going to get really uncomfortable because I'm really not going to remember this conversation. And then I'll be like, oh yeah, totally, Phil. Welcome back, Phil. And then act really hurt when it seems like I don't know who you are. That's your job. I'm the one of the unnamed children of the vine, so you're a grape, is what you're telling me. Crumpet is kind of cute. I like food names, even if I've never eaten one before. You've never eaten food? I know. Alright, cool. Glad we're on the same page, Phil. What is a crumpet? It's like some kind of pastry, but like, what kind of pastry? Wine is just vine with the extra V. I mean, I suppose. I would say vine with an extra V is vavine. They don't call it a double V. They should, but they don't. And you got to stick by the rules. Need more of a jaw right in here. They do call it that in French, double V. Well, this ain't France, is it, Corey? Isn't it like an English muffin? It might be. All I know is you, at least stereotypically, have it with tea. A crumpet is a small griddled bread made from an unsweetened batter of water or milk, flour, and yeast. Popular in the United Kingdom, Canada, New Zealand, South Africa, and Australia, crumpets are regionally known as picklets, a name also applied to a thinner, more pancake-like griddle bread. A type of the latter is referred to as a crumpet in Scotland. It's because V is V, so W is double V. Or double V. I see. But we're in America, so we talk American around here. Alright, yeehaw and all that. At least I'm in America. And as an American, I believe I'm the only one that matters. We eat our freedom fries and like it. Exactly. Don't mess with the French. Why, do you have a history with them? You're the only one who matters? Oh, don't say that. My ego doesn't need to get any more inflated than it already is. They still regularly construct guillotines outside of the president's house. Don't want to piss those people off. They'd have to figure out where I live before they could construct a guillotine in front of my house. And then I'd just move and start the whole process all over again. Bring it on, the French. You can't construct guillotines outside of every house. I hope. Something is strangely phallic. I think you're looking for a pH there. Could be worse. You could be English. Not just as self-important as an American, but also getting mad that people don't recognize it. Like, sorry, your country is irrelevant now. You've been demoted. V5OFUM. Yes, we've come full circle to bashing on the English again. I know it was delusional to hope it, but I was really hoping they would dissolve the monarchy. I heard the news and I was like, so we can be done then, right? And they were like, no, of course not. We've crowned a new king. Okay. And you're part of the Western world, right? Still taking orders from Somebody in a big chair that happens to have the right blood. Cool, cool. Clearly, Grape meant follic as in follicle, and is asking for hair on your sculpture. Oh, we'll get to the hair. That's a good call, though. That's probably what they meant. Sofa, I don't even understand what that was supposed to mean. I'm out of water, but I don't want to go up and downstairs to get more. I saw the news and heard nothing but crab rave. They still might. Wales hates the man and wants to abolish the title Prince of Wales entirely, so William can't get it. Don't give me hope, Kenna. I can't get burned again. I was banking on this in the last monarchy transition, and I can't wait another 70 years. Years, dude has like 10 tops. Fair enough. But he'll probably just like pass some special law that says he remains king even in the grave. He'll have like a royal psychic, a royal medium come to the gravesite and take edicts from his tombstone. I guess they're probably in like a mausoleum or something. I don't know, I didn't watch the funeral. Can't we just have some cat be king? I mean, he just can't wait. Surprising that the general population hasn't gone mental over the cost of the royal funeral and coronation celebrations the family has suggested. And they have, says Kinna. I mean, I would be pretty upset. But I would be upset about pretty much everything related to the monarchy. The only reason we didn't hear it from the UK is the BBC is literally owned by the Crown. Yep. It's government funded. Yeah, but the government is the Crown, so they're not going to say bad things about, you know, the people that own them. Who are they? John Oliver? Wrong British people. But Sky News and The Guardian and all have reported about how unpopular the monarchy is, especially the cost. That's good, at least. At least there's a source somewhere for that. I'll try and drop the camera down a little lower. For legal reasons, Twitch, this is all hypothetical. What's hypothetical? What are we talking about? I was just speaking in gibberish. Random words coming out of my mouth. No, it's not. Fuck the British monarchy. I'll get my friend on it. I'm not seeing any monarchies being overthrown yet. Cut to the chase. Yeah, no, I'd be perfectly happy to see the monarchy end. It's outdated, doesn't even begin to describe the problem. Not literally, though. They're way too inbred. Honestly, getting some other genes in there might be good for them. Then again, you may introduce some sort of genetic illness that they're not equipped for. Or something. Is that how genetics work? It is now. God, the irony of invading the British royal family and introducing a disease that they weren't prepared for. That was Diana and Meghan, but look how those went. Yeah, yeah. Send in the modified mosquito squad. Hemophilia already runs in the royal blood. Is that right? Now, I'm not one to make plans here. But is there anything we can work with there? I got to assume Twitch doesn't care about idle conversation. Send in the paper airplane squad. Yeah, in a very real way, they're a sickly level of inbred. It's amazing what money can do, isn't it? Like, people who are genetically disadvantaged like that should not live to be 90. Send in the paper airplane squad. That got me. Beware! Minor lesions. Lesions? Lacerations. That's what I was going for. Okay, so we're going to start with a tumbler nose and then work our way from there. It's actually supposed to be a little lower than that. Maybe like there. What's tumbler nose? Do you know that art style where it was very popular on Tumblr, where they, like, everybody just made the nose like red. I know that you make the nose red in order to, like, just show color and blood in the face, but there was this, like, really common art style for Tumblr comics and artwork and stuff that involved just a very round, kind of teardrop-shaped nose that was much redder than the rest of the face. It was like they have a cold level of red at the tip. Yes, exactly. Exactly. Corey knows what I'm talking about. E-girl. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And they're usually like a really kind of bubbly art style. Not all too dissimilar from mine, to be honest, in terms of like the general aesthetic of the characters. Well, my cuddly style. I kind of have the two. I have the cuddly and the creepy. But yeah, exactly. You're picking up what I'm throwing down. I feel like that already makes him look way less horrifying. A nose helps a lot. Take notes, Voldemort. This is kind of looking Putin-y all of a sudden. Well, he is shirtless. I see it a little bit. It won't feel that way when the hair goes on. He's got big, long, hanging hair from this hair. This is like a ledge to hang the hair pieces off of. It's not his actual hairline. You shouldn't throw art unless it's a performance piece. That's true. But it can really make a statement, which I guess is why it would make good performance art. You know what? No. Throw the art. Throw all the art. I reject your rules, Kinna. I reject your establishment. Hair? He already looks like Bruce Willis. Well, but he's not Bruce Willis, so adding hair is probably a good move. This is getting there. Okay, we just kind of... Whoop! We're on a sailboat. Well, yeah, well, I'm anti-disestablishmentarian, so there. A throwback. I respect it. I know that crease there looks good, but we're going to get rid of it for now and bring it back later. I'm going to try and bring this to a finer point and then kind of draw it downward a little bit because he does have a bit of a, like a hooked nose. It's a little crooked. There we go. Push it over like that. Or I guess it wasn't crooked enough. I made it crooked, but it looks better now. I don't know how to describe that. Kidda. Oh, that's looking pretty nice. Nose really makes a lot of difference to make him look much more human. Okay, this is one of those times I wish I'd trim my fingernails. But hopefully we don't cause too much damage. We're just gonna kinda... Bring it down a little bit. Not too much. Just a little. That's like when there's a character drawing and it looks like crap until you give it pupils and it's instantly 1,000 times better. Exactly. Yes, it is. It is precisely like that. I mean, we popped a nose on him, and he still has horrifying soulless eyes. But he looks like a person with horrifying soulless eyes. Nose. Oh, it's an acronym. Let me see. Never observed superior experiences. Next October, sell eggs. Naples offers seasonal education. Take your pick. No one say anything. I want to point this a little bit, but I really like where this is at, so I'm going to use the dull tool to do it and just slowly work my way up to it. 9178. Of course. The face makes you think of a blobfish. I feel like it's much more vertically stretched than a blobfish. And that's not me taking offense, I truly don't see what you're talking about. Never overestimate seasonal eggnog. Nocturnal owls sleep early. That's a good one and accurate. If you vertically stretched a blobfish, it would look like this. Alright, I'll buy that. I accept these terms. Sorry, I know this is in shadow, but I need the angle to see what I'm doing. It'll come back to you shortly. Nasty old schnoz, Elder. Topical. I can dig it. Need to thin it out. I do like the idea of including the word within the acronym for recursive acronizing. That adds an extra challenge that my brain will likely not handle. We're gonna cause a short circuit, and I'm gonna come up with nothing at all. Nasty ostriches sound earth. Indeed. Those are definitely words that start with those letters. It's another one in the vein of 9178. Did I say something different? What'd I say? Have I done it again? As in sounding like what you do to radar underwater. Oh, yeah. Those of us on planet Earth call that listening. But I guess you sound alarms. Basically sticking their heads in the ground. Okay, you're arguing your way towards a better explanation. I'll give you points for that. Nightly operas sound extra. Okay, operas, like, that's enough. Take it easy. It's beginning to remind you of salad fingers. I'm sure we'll go through many stages of metamorphosis. All of them creepy, it seems. But I can't argue with you. Nostrils observer... I'm going to go with observe. Nostrils observe smelly eggplant. I think we need a chin dimple. North Ohio starts east. Ostriches don't hide when they stick their heads in the underground. They're scanning. Gotta watch out for those ostrich scans. They can see more than you think. I'm not gonna have ostriches scanning me. Seeing what my feet look like without socks on. Perverts. Nose observes some essence. Very nice. And once again, including the original root word. Bonus points for Corey. Okay, I'm gonna add this whole thing and it's gonna look like Rick's eyebrow for a second. But we'll fix that by shaving down the middle. I just need there to be more brow happening here. We're gonna put that on there and kind of smooth it into place. In fact, we can kind of add a raise and then follow that. I have this running trend ever since I was a little kid of doing a cocked eyebrow on characters. I don't know why that is. I like the idea of calling an ultrasound an ultra-listen. I think it's more accurate. Nah, orangutans sell envelopes. What I want to know is what the first part of that conversation was. Vine boom sound. The Pixar eyebrow. Sorta, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I did draw a lot of Pixar characters when I was a kid, so I'm sure that's where I picked it up. The DreamWorks face. My brother also was known for cocking his eyebrow all the time, and he could do, like, the eyebrow dance thing. And I was, one of those little brothers that was obsessed with my older brother. So that's probably also largely where it came from. Lightning McQueen did it the best. Well, he did have a lot more eye to work with. If you wanna be fair. And we're gonna dial this back down, but this is a good place to start. What did the cars eat before they invented oil refineries, though? Did they just spawn with them? I think you have to accept that oil refineries were naturally recurring for the cars. Or maybe oil just springs out of the ground, naturally refined like water in their universe. They don't seem to have people, so they must have completely different rules, right? Oh, good night, Kenna. I missed your goodnight message. Have a good night. Thanks for hanging out. See you next time. This is going to need to come down quite a bit from where it is right now, but we'll get it there. Ken is right, I gotta get up in 7 hours, so I should probably try to sleep too. Alright, Moody, go to bed. Get some rest. Have a good day tomorrow. Technically, I have to get up in about the same amount of time. But I'll be on for another half hour or so. See if we can get this brow line the way I like it, or at least the beginnings of it. That's Crumpet to you. I'm sorry. Good night, Crumpet. I have to be up in 4? Leo, welcome, welcome. Good to see you. You have a new name now, but I can't remember what it is. I think it was Timothy. To be up in 4 hours. That's brutal. I love that Moody has fully embraced the name Crumpet. I hope you're still here to hear me say that. I'm the new Leo, also known as Leopold. Crumpet was an inspired choice. Thank you. I should have gone with, like, pet-style names for everybody. Need to take another crack at it. I want to make sure this is fully merged to the face before I start shaving stuff away. It looks a little, Prometheus and Bob right now. Kind of the two combined into a single person, actually. I have a bird name. Grape? That's a bird name? I guess it would make a good bird name. If I had a bird, I would name it Grape. He looks like Neocortex. He takes on many forms. Is it bad that my chest cracks like that? That seems bad. I don't know if you heard that. When I stretch my shoulders, like if I like pull my arms back for a big stretch, my chest, like my sternum pops. Should I be worried about that? It's been happening since I was a young kid. Posture check. Good call, Corey. Posture check achieved. Anybody has any medical know-how and thinks I should be concerned about that, just give me a holler. I've been worried about that for, well, I don't know, I guess about 27 years. That's right. As a newborn baby, I was terrified. And then we're just going to try and, like, go across the entire surface of this and flatten it out. Mine does that, too, when I stretch my shoulders back. I can't breathe. That seems bad. I can breathe. I just have to deal with a poppy sternum. Cats wants another insult, you say? This just in. That's right, we're going for a title format one. This just in. Cats is amazing at Super Mario Maker 2. Is hardcore simping over whoever Cats is. And it's not reciprocated. There's no return, simp. That's right, you heard me. You asked for the heat and I brought it. Try not to put too much weight on the nose. I needed it to kind of anchor me while I was working on the other features, which is why I put the nose in. But now I gotta be careful and kind of walk on eggshells around it because I don't want to deform it. That'd be bad. Ooh, getting ever closer to the monthly push-ups. What does the percentage say? 16K. How many are needed for that one? Quite a few. Oh, but there are still 23 days left on that one. I should make that one a contest. If it goes all the way for the whole month without being filled out, then I get to take a push-up off. That seems fair to me. Sofa. Not gonna let me get away with it, eh? I feel like if it doesn't make it, you should have to do twice as many push-ups. Now that doesn't make any sense at all. I like that you're coming up with ideas, and I like that you're throwing stuff out there. But I'm going to go ahead and say no. No to that one. That's what I feel in my heart. It's a great idea until I don't stream for 3 weeks. Hey! It's only going to be 1 week. And it's because of a planned vacation. I'm back for real this time, damn it. Got the website set up. There's a video coming out tomorrow. Just a stream cut down, but it's something. Forcing myself to edit. That was a good insult. Thank you, cats. I try. Merch panel links to the wrong site, by the way. Yeah, I know. The new merch store isn't up yet, and I'm just going to leave that as clunky until I fix it, because it should be up later this week. I know that's super jank and I should just take it down in the meantime, but I'm not going to do that. They're getting ready to tap out those monthly push-ups. I guess it's time for a vacation. I wish I could take a vacation on that kind of notice. We had to tell work about this, like, I don't know, what, 2 months ago? I guess that's not that unreasonable. For a whole week vacation. It'll be a big one, though. I'm looking forward to it. Well, Emily and I have never taken an actual vacation together. Just the two of us. And we've been together for, you know, it's going to be 8 years in January. In a year, I can finally crash UEcraft 2? I don't know, we'll see. That wasn't an age thing, that was just a OG server members thing. Kinda wound it back to the original crew to keep the numbers small. Getting ready to go to bed, but I got a new alarm clock, and I think you'll enjoy it, so I'm going to talk about it first. Hit me with it, Leo. What's the new alarm clock? Please tell us about everything wrong with this alarm clock. Hit us with it. What's the story? Does it, like, fire alligators at you or something? I've been sleeping like shit, so I've been sleeping through my alarms. I bought a wristband that shocks me as an alarm clock and will continue to shock me every 15 seconds until I get up and do jumping jacks. Man, I need an alarm clock like that. That sounds like a pretty reliable system. It's pretty effective. I feel like if I did that, I would eventually just, like that episode of Futurama where Leela has a shock collar for her temper. I would just grow to love the shocks. I thought I did enough jumping jacks this morning, and boy, was I wrong. Does it check your heart rate or something? Like, do you have to get that to a certain point? It's got motion sensors in it. Also, it has a built-in step counter. Alright, so it's not screwing around. You can't swing your arm around while you're still in bed, I've tried. Well, yeah, otherwise it could be fixed by a little morning ritual, if you know what I mean. You can't have that. Oops, that was loud, aggressive, I apologize. Here we are just having a chill stream, and I'm dropping tools and making waves. I don't like this Hershey ad. Two boys are trick-or-treating, they're given a full-size candy bar, and then a girl shows up dressed as two pieces of candy and get the two candies, while the boys give a bad look. For sure... off camera, they're taking her bag. I don't like that either. I don't know what I'm reading, but I don't like it. Missed 5 weeks of school because you sleep through alarms? That's a lot. Yeah, it sounds like you need a shock wristband also, Sofa. Going to bed? I did enjoy that, Leo. Thank you for sharing. Have a good night. And have a good day at work tomorrow. Thanks for hanging out. 5 weeks of sleep is a very long nap. You're right about that. You thought something fell in your room. I'm sorry, cats. That's my bad. I'm just trying to upset people. It's what I live for. It's what makes me me. I'm too close again, aren't I? Gotta be careful, I'm gonna flatten out Tucker's old man butt. This is looking pretty good. School's only been in 2 months. You've missed 5 weeks in the first 2 months? It's quite a bit of school to miss. I think we made a lot of progress on this face over the course of one evening. I do like that brow. That's about as much as I need, and it looks a lot more reasonable from the side. It doesn't look as much like a caveman, and adds some shape that I think looks good from most angles. Oh, we gotta add a jaw on this side also. Let me see if I can raise the camera up a little bit so you can see what I'm doing with that. That'll be right in here. Nope, hold on. A little higher. Something like that, I think. That is a long neck. Yes, it is. And it's exaggerated, but it'll look better with the clothes on. He's got a very frumpy outfit, and I wanted his features to still be, like, recognizable. But yes, it is a very long neck. It's no wiglet, but it's a long neck. Not quite wiglet status. I gotta up my game. What does simp mean? I'm getting multiple definitions. I don't know, I'm too old to know what the actual definition is. As far as I'm aware, it means affectionately pursuing someone. It's a new Pokemon. I'm pretty sure I'm not supposed to say it on Twitch anymore. Probably banned for it. I don't think there was a big enough glob. I read pimp. That's a classic Pokemon. I was suggesting that you were pining. It's called baking a chocolate cake for a girl and just expecting her to go out with you. Been there, done that. Boy, if I had a nickel. That's actually a pretty rough one, Sofa. Sorry to hear that. Unfortunately, the heart wants what it wants, even if the stomach wants chocolate cake. My friend that I like tells me about the guys she talks to from dating apps. Pimp, that's rough, buddy. I'm sorry to hear that. I've been in that situation before. That is very brutal, my friend. For me, it was before the time of dating apps, but she talked to me about the guys she was interested in. I know that feeling. Is that in the right spot? Yeah, I think I just need to push it in more. I mean, if they're a friend, then, you know, obviously they're a friend. And you can keep being there for them. But if you're pursuing something there and that's the kind of response you're getting, it's time to search other trails. The girl I like talks to me about all the boys in her class. Oh. Well then. Yeah, I mean that was more or less the situation I was in. That was back in high school. And then that very actually it was junior high school. Wow, it's a long time ago. Then at the end of junior high school, we all went to a pool party at. Oops, how did I switch that? We all went to a pool party at one of our friends' houses, and she was told by the guy I thought was my best friend that I liked her in a game of truth or dare, because, you know, in truth or dare, they ask you truths about your friends. Not about you. It was after I left the party. I was there for a little while, and then I left toward, like, somewhere in the middle of Truth or Dare. And they asked the guy I thought was my best friend, who I liked, and he told them, even though she was sitting right there. Cool dude. In high school, that very same guy tried to have sex with my girlfriend, knowing full well that she was my girlfriend. Good guy. He told his parents I did something to him. I don't know what. But they always gave me glares at water polo games and stuff. As though I was some kind of monster. So I have no idea what he told them I did. I think you're using the word friend wrong. He was my friend. After the junior high school thing, he was no longer my friend. Yes. Yeah, he was a terrible friend. But I, most often don't really know how to pick good friends. I'm fairly socially inept. And, that tends to backfire. I was in Truth or Dare and I got dared to go home. Ugh. That's brutal. That's pretty rough. Even after I paid for pizza, sofa. No. I hope you didn't hang out with those people again. They're not worth your time. I think we made a lot of really good progress on this face today. Oh, sofa. I feel for you, buddy. That's a rough time. Well, that's when you call the cops and say they had booze at the party. Pimp, stay toxic. I love it. I told them to keep the pizza ass wipe. That's a good call. Yeah. And then you poisoned the pizza, right? No, I don't condone poisoning anybody. But I am curious. Did you poison the pizza? It would be totally not a good idea to do to anyone. Don't poison people. But just hypothetically. I only support false arrest. No, don't go swatting people. That uses up valuable police time that they could spend arresting innocent people. So I guess really it's all in a day's work. I bet they didn't tip. They probably got a nice pube garnish. I sure hope so. Although, it's a little late in the game on the part of the pizza man to pull a move like that after finding out you didn't get tipped. Just be like, oh, no tip? Cool, cool. Let me see that pizza for a second. I just have to check something in my car. I don't know if that's going to play out. Alright, folks. Well, I hope you enjoyed hanging out with me. I sure had a blast, as always. That's going to be it for tonight. Emily and I will be back on Friday. We'll be returning to Spore and seeing what we can accomplish in the space stage. And, I'll be back next week with possibly more of this, but maybe some drawing. 6 out of 10 would do it again. I'll take that 6. That's pretty good. I'll take that. That's a solid D. I accept it. I'm addicted to Kiss's accordion song. Well, don't do too much of it. You'll go blind. Back to Spore. Yes, indeed. See you Friday. Alrighty, everybody. Have a good rest of your night. Ungreetings. Farewell. Stay safe, everybody. You especially, Sofa. I mean, everybody stay safe. You get what I'm trying to say. All right. Bye, everyone.